here with the Renegade Health Show, and today we are not in my kitchen, but we're in my friend's kitchen, and we are actually in Vegas, and we're going to show you guys how to do smoothies Vegas style.
Yes, and we just did actually an amazing Bikram session. Yeah. So after that, believe me, all you need is a nice superfood smoothie to replenish all the stuff that we just released out of our body.
Yeah, they took me to a Bikram yoga class, and it was awesome.
And you loved it. Come
on, I did. I loved it. I like the challenge.
Yes. So cool. Today, this is the base for the smoothie is the most important thing, because that's what makes the smoothie pretty much. That's the secret that Len Foley told me. And normally what you want to put on a base, you want to put all the oils so it breaks down and it actually doesn't make your smoothie, you know, thick and kind of gives it a nice flavor and a texture. So this is what we put in a base. Start with some cashews.
Okay.
This I have here is a mix of Chinese herbs and mushrooms. It has reishi, spirulina, romania, goji berries, shizandra berries, and a bunch of other stuff that I can't even remember.
And all those mushrooms, as you guys know, are so great on our immune system.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Now we put pretty much like one dropper full, maybe a little bit more, of vanilla stevia, sweetness. We also got some local desert honey. As you know, honey is the best for you as soon as it's from where you live.
Mm-hmm.
I normally blend some hemp seeds. You can add them later, but when you add them later, they kind of make the smoothie extremely thick, so they absorb a lot. But it's awesome protein source, so I tried it both ways, and I think this way works better for me, tastes better, and it doesn't have that kind of gooey texture. It's not the best. Alright, so I put normally like 1 to 2 tablespoons, if you prefer, you know, whatever you like, pretty much will work. Then we add 2 tablespoons of coconut oil.
Yeah, this is an intense smoothie. Like I said, it's Vegas style.
Total, I would say there's total ingredients in all of it.
Look at all that.
45 maybe ingredients.
And
just because of the teas. And the Chinese tea, there is 9 mushrooms and herbs. And then in this tea that I'm about to pour, we have 6 herbs. There's catsquat, chuchuwasi, powdery arco, a little bit of chamomile. We have this nice, really nice mix, ginseng vitality. It has a whole bunch of stuff in it. Tastes really good. And a little bit of jasmine for flavor.
So you use the tea instead of water?
Yes, because the key is to have hot base so you can break down all the oils.
Ah.
And a little bit of salt to bring out the sweetness. So just like 2 pinches of salt. And that will be it for the base.
That's a culinary trick, is salt to really help bring out sweetness.
Who would think, huh?
Who would think?
All right, so we're going to blend this in. Get my corn on, sorry. That should be enough. I've been doing this kind of type of smoothie for about 1.5 years, and every time I make it, it tastes different. So I couldn't figure out what's the deal, you know? I tried doing one way, the other way, whatever, 15th way, and it still tastes different, and I'm trying to kind of repeat myself, but it doesn't really work. And
but does it always taste good?
It tastes good, yes, it tastes good. It just sometimes it's more thicker, sometimes more liquidy, sometimes it's more whatever, ashwagandha, you know, or more chilajiri. Not the best taste ever, but anyway. So I tried a couple days ago actually putting berries in this mix first instead of all the powders, because this is hot. And when you put, you know, all stuff that doesn't really taste all that delicious, it enhances the flavor because it kind of like, you know, it makes it pretty much stronger.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to try put frozen berries and some banana first, and it came out so good. So
I've made smoothies with tea, with a tea base before, mm-hmm. but I've never done it with the tea still warm, so I'm intrigued to try this.
Because we're normally, actually, before we bought Vitamix, we just had like a regular hand blender, all sorts of mixed berries, so it kind of now is going to cool down a little bit, but not enough to kind of, you know, mix all the oils again together.
Mm-hmm.
and it gives already a nice flavor. If you mix this stuff together, it will be really delicious. First thing, normally I would put cacao. Depends also if you would like it more chocolatey. You can put like 3 tablespoons, and it actually makes it really strong because this cacao is very potent. Mm-hmm.
This is why I'm filming today, guys, and not Kevin. Kevin doesn't do cacao.
He doesn't? No.
No. Yeah.
Next thing I put is tocotrienols, which is a really good source of vitamin E.
Mm-hmm.
And it tastes really good, actually, so it gives it a nice flavor, so I put like a few tablespoons of that.
Great. It helps thicken it a little bit, too.
Yeah, not too much, though. And the next thing is activated barley. It's an Wari product. Almost a tablespoon of that. Yeah. And then next thing is ashwagandha. That thing is so strong. If you put a little bit more of that, you're gonna have yourself an ashwagandha smoothie. And I don't care what else you put in there, it's gonna taste just like ashwagandha.
So kind of bitter, right?
It's just, I don't know, it has that distinct kind of flavor that it's kind of really hard to wash off if you put too much.
Mm-hmm.
So as you can tell, I put like really, really little. It's not even like maybe a third of a teaspoon.
Wow.
Because when I got it, I'm like, I don't know how much to put it. I dumped the whole tablespoon, and I'm like, okay. And a steak.
Live and learn.
Yes, every day. Next thing, I put mesquite. Awesome sweetener. Mm-hmm. Really good, really good. Tastes delicious.
Yeah, I love mesquite.
So I put like really and maca. Can't go without maca. Have it.
Yeah. Great.
Next thing, we put a little bit of hemp protein. You gotta have some kind of protein kind of base. So, and hemp is extremely good, especially in powder form. Remember, we put a little bit of hemp seeds as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, and some MSM powder.
MSM is a sulfur, and it's really good for your joints. It's good for your collagen. It's good for your hair and your nails and your skin.
Well, the girl talk, huh?
Yeah.
Also, the last thing, I believe, that not yet, that we put is chia seeds.
Oh, great.
Really good source of fiber.
Mm-hmm. And omegas.
And omegas, yes. I put two tablespoons of that. And what else? And now we use almond milk or hemp milk or coconut water. We're gonna use some coconut water to pretty much, that's gonna be our liquid for the day. Good morning, actually. All right, this is gonna be our final mix, and we are about to taste the most delicious smoothie I've ever had. You can see it's very liquidy, actually, after all the hemp that we put and chia seeds and all that.
It's got a good consistency. It's getting close so you guys can see that. Great.
All right, so let's see how it came up this one, right? This time.
Cheers. Mmm.
Right?
Yeah, it's really tasty. Wow.
Really good.
I'm in for a treat with this amazing superfood Vegas style smoothie. Thank you so much.
Thank you too.
Yeah. This is Amory Gianni and
Oksana Shalepa.
And together we can help change the health of the world one show at a time. And I almost forgot about our question of the day. We always ask a question of the day for our viewers.
Uh-oh.
Can you come up with a question to ask them? It could be on anything. It could be on
question for the viewers to answer.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
We have them posted on the blog below.
What is the best source of fiber for you? Because I know a lot of people actually suffer from digestive orders, and it's not the best, you know, thing in the world. So kind of you always want to keep your intestines flowing. So what's for you? Works the best?
Great. Great question. What's the best fiber for you? What works best for you? Go ahead and post it down below. We'll see you tomorrow.
Bye.